Kumusta kayo lahat? Welcome to Pinoy Crossover, the basketball show for the Filipino community. My name is PJ, Marky Marks right here. As you can see, we are in Toronto, not in the studio, and we're outside Jurassic Park, Jurassic World, Raptors Nation. What up, Marky Mark? What can you say about being here?
I mean, we've been here last year. It was a great experience, and game one wasn't what we wanted to be, but game two is here, and we're here to win it, and we're excited to be here outside. I know the weather is not good, but we're going to make it happen, right?
Let's talk about game one, because that was you mentioned off camera conspiracy, but talk about game one and let's analyze what happened, or what questions can you ask about that?
I wanted to ask first you, PJ, do you feel like the Raptors lost that game, or did you feel like the Cavs stole that game from them?
I feel that the Raptors lost it. They blew it. You know, they had leads at second half, and they also had the lead at the fourth quarter. They couldn't close the game, and LeBron, being a great player, he closed it for them, and he had made that nice tying shot against the rookie. So LeBron's great, and Raps weren't great enough.
The funny thing is that the Cavs never led the whole game. Like, if you from first to till the end of the fourth quarter, that's when they were able to really pull it off. And they were getting off one rest, where Raptors had a few games really of rest since they finished it off in game six against the Wizards. And LeBron really showed he didn't have a great game. People knew. He was 12 of 30 from the field, but he had a triple-double. And his cast, the supporting cast, really came up in the overtime. Kevin Love made a bunch of threes. GR made a bunch of threes. And it was just a lesson learned, hopefully, for the Raptors coming into game two, right? What about, like I mentioned to you, the conspiracy. Did you feel like there's this conspiracy about LeBron being this big kryptonite against Lowry and DeRozan? Or do you think it's just, you know, all talks, it's just all this crazy talks that everyone's talking about? And not just in social media, but everyone, all the fans in the NBA.
Well, LeBron's just great in general. I think any team that he faces, he will rub off that. He will prove that he's the king, you know. So when he faced the Raptors, no one could contain him. LeBron, he was shooting bad, but when it came to it, he made some crucial shots in order to lift his team up. And even though they weren't playing the best game, LeBron wasn't shooting the best, and his team came off, again, like you said, they weren't rested. They still came out with the win, and it just shows how LeBron can play so well at the crucial moments, and the Raptors couldn't really do anything about it.
It shows a lot of his greatness, and, like, you know, all these crazy conspiracy about him having the numbers or just having this mindset, like, you know, getting on the minds of DeRozan and Lowry. I don't think it's true. I think Lowry and DeRozan are great players, and they've overcome a lot of playoff, you know, adverse challenges that they've had before. They were being criticized for how they play in the playoffs, but now they overcame it. And I feel like this is the time that they have, because they have the right supporting cast. They have the right players that surrounds them in terms of, you know, the kind of players that would help them when they need to overcome a challenge like LeBron. Not just LeBron, but the cast that they have at Cleveland Cavaliers, right? What do you think is, for me, do you think that they should be worried coming into game two? Do you think, what are some of the things that they should fix in terms of what they did in game one to be better in game two?
Well, I think Cavs are gonna adapt their lineup. For example, in the first game, Jonas was going to town. They were playing big, and Jonas was bullying him down low. He scored a lot of points until, you know, Cavs switched it to match Jonas. And then, obviously, Jonas couldn't make the baskets at the end. He missed, like, maybe four at the fourth quarter. But they have to just play, again, strongly in the first couple of minutes. And if they can't close it out, then LeBron and his team will find a way, because they'll be more rested in game two, right?
I agree as well. And this is our main key points, I guess, for game two, as we're watching it now, because once we air this, the game's going to be done. But these are some of the key points that I have for them. First is that they just took play consistently from their first game. I think they did a great job from the first quarter until the last few minutes of the fourth quarter. If they can keep that intensity, I think they're going to win the game. So the only thing that I'm worried about, the second key point that I have, is just don't panic in the last quarter, in the last few minutes of the game. Just keep playing the way they've always been playing the whole season, because we noticed a lot of isolation basketball. They noticed a lot of DeRozan pick and roll that didn't really have a lot of movement. That's why they weren't able to get a lot of good baskets in the rim and a lot of good shots, because DeRozan was and Lowry was shut down because LeBron guarded him in the fourth quarter. So they just should be prepared for that, because once LeBron guards Lowry, DeRozan and other guards has to step up and take advantage of the mismatches, because LeBron's going to be away from the basket, right?
Yeah. Oh, wait, we have a special guest. Just came out of nowhere. Raptors cage, all these Raptors fans.
Go, man. You know
talk about game one. LeBron, what was the main thing that LeBron, we didn't win game one?
main thing in game one, they didn't focus. Four shots on the basket, and they missed. Valanciunas, why didn't you dunk it?
Jonas was like, playing such a great game,
like,
too.
7 foot odd, like, yo, straight up, if they don't get it this year, I'm going to try out for the team next year, and I don't even play ball.
Again, Raptors fans are pretty angered because we had a clear path to win that game, and, you know, we couldn't close. No. And we had the shots, you know, Fred VanVleet had a couple of shots to win it, and, you know, Jonas again. And it's about trusting the process. We had such a great year. It's about closing and finishing it where it matters. Hey, we had some good opinions, yeah. And as you can see right now, everyone's coming into Jurassic Park and ready to support the Raptors. That's the good thing about the Raptors and the Raptor fan base is everyone's here to support.
Rain or shine, we're here. Not just, you know, we're here. The fans are here watching the game, soaking wet right now. It's raining really hard, but we're here because we love the Raptors. We're passionate about them. We the North. We know they can win and they can get a really good series out of this matchup against the Cavs.